Hello everybody, I am the Mad Witch and welcome back to another video. So, last episode was a resistance episode and it was pretty cool because we got to fly an X-Wing, and even though we didn't really get to see it flying around, we still got to pick what type of maneuvers we got to perform while flying, and I think that was pretty cool. So this episode, like I said, since we're going to be flip-flopping, this episode is going to be a scoundrel episode. And at the end of last episode, we picked up a new mission for Hondo, which was to go on a business trip. And I'm super excited for this mission because I'm pretty sure we're going to be going on the Millennium Falcon this episode. So that's dope. All right, so let's see. It is 4 in the morning for our dear Sim, and let's see, she is well rested but very hungry, so we're gonna get her some food and then get to work on prepping for this mission. So let's go to docking bay 7. Alright, so between last episode and today's episode, my brother and I think I told you guys, we've been re-watching Clone Wars, and we finished it, so... Oh, did we ever read this? I don't think we did. Strano Cookie Tugs. A master of galactic cuisine, Strano Cookie Tugs runs a food freighter business that is renowned across the galaxy. He's currently hard at work serving his unique dishes in Docking Bay 7 and Black Spire Outpost. Thank you for being here, Cookie. Okay, we've got 1,000 credits. We can over 1,000 credits. I'm gonna try the Felucian Garden spread. But anyways, yeah, so my brother and I, we finished the Clone Wars. And it was kind of funny because, like, my brother, he's seen, like, bits and pieces of the show over the years, but he's like worked so hard for the past 2 years to avoid spoilers for season 7, the final season. And honestly, I'm like so proud of him. Like, he's way stronger than I am to, you know, like, to be able to avoid spoilers for that long, you know? So it was pretty fun watching the final season because he, like, straight up had no idea what was going on. He, you know, like, didn't know what was happening with, like, Ahsoka's storyline. He, you know, didn't know that we were gonna get to see, you know, Maul come back and stuff like that. Like, there's just so much that he didn't know, and I was just loving watching his reactions to things, you know, because it's like, you know, I've seen the show, I think this is like my 4th time watching through the Clone Wars, and so watching it through, you know, his new perspective was just lovely. But yeah, let's see what we've got to do to get started here. Oh, also, so we finished, purchase scoundrel gear, that seems like a good thing to do. Anyways, so since we finished Clone Wars, we have started Rebels, and that's another show that Aaron, my brother, he doesn't really know a lot about. So I've only watched through Rebels once. I've seen the first 2 seasons twice, though. Because I started the show with my dad, and then he started watching it without me, and I never really caught up. And so then I watched it by myself, so I restarted the first 2 seasons, just so I could kind of, like, jog my memory and say, okay, that's where we are now. But, yeah, so I've seen the first 2 seasons, I've seen the... Brain. Words. Okay. So I've seen seasons 1 and season 2 twice, but I think is there 4 seasons or 5 seasons? I don't know. Point is, the other seasons I've only seen once, and since I can't even remember how many seasons there are, that's probably like a good indicator that I don't really know. So yeah, it's gonna be interesting because it's gonna be my brother's first time going through all of the episodes. But it's also gonna be fun for me because I don't really remember this show. I don't remember Rebels as much as I remember Clone Wars. There's glitches in The Sims today. I can only buy data spikes? Might as well buy one. I've got a lightsaber. So use that. Let's see, what else can I do? So items like, okay, prepare for the business trip. Items like a blaster pistol, droid, thermal detonator, or fake ID may be helpful. These items can be obtained from Hondo or the Holo table if you have enough reputation with that faction. Dang, so this is gonna be an interesting trip. Maybe I should have saved this for later. Because I don't think I have enough cred to use the Resistance Holo table right now. And apparently a blaster pistol, droid. I mean, I have a droid. A droid could be helpful. But a thermal detonator, a blaster, or a fake ID. Apparently, I think Hondo does have those things, but I don't have enough cred with the scoundrels, so he won't sell that to me. And, where's my droid? Where's my droid? Hang on. My droid's not in my inventory, so where's my droid? Oh, there you are. Why are you, like, all the way over here? Alright, engage follow protocol. Jeez. Honestly, this thing. Okay. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so this might be a bit more of a bumpy ride than I would like. Because I don't have enough cred with Hondo or the Resistance to be able to buy a blaster or a detonator or a fake ID. But I do have a droid, which could come in handy. So maybe this won't be as bad as I think it is. All right, so step one was to prepare for the trip by purchasing things. Step two, complete business trip. Click on the Millennium Falcon to go on a business trip. All right. So here is the moment we've all been waiting for. Look at it! Ah! Okay, all right. You can attempt the Kessel Run? Oh my goodness. We can't explore yet. Requires max scoundrel reputation to explore the Millennium Falcon. Dang. We can scan the Millennium Falcon. We'll do that later. But for now, go on a business trip. Alright, and the droid is following me. Okay. Alright. Can we watch them enter the ship? Where's the... There's the ramp. Can we watch them go up, or do they just disappear? They just disappear. All right, I want to watch it take off though. Look at it! Ah! I hope you don't mind me tagging along, my friend. It's not that I don't trust you. I just don't want to miss out on all the fun, Hondo says cheerfully. We've got a couple unique opportunities to earn some credits. First, a business associate of mine on Kessel needs spice moved to Takadana. Discreetly, of course. Second, Agagara, yes, of August Cantina, has entrusted Ohnaka Transport Solutions with the honor of hauling gold lichen to Coruscant. Which one tickles your fancy? So we can either run spice or deliver lichen. Is it lichen or... I want to say it's lichen. Let's do the deal for Aga. We're gonna transport golden lichen to Coruscant. That might be safer, but that also might be the more boring option. And I feel like boring is kind of good, I guess, considering I don't have a blaster or a detonator or a fake ID. Ooh, this one might have required a fake ID. Okay, let's see. Chewbacca, Hondo, and Isabel head to the Surabat vicinity. They land in a large clearing near a farming village. A tough woman approaches. Did Aga send you? The crates of golden lichen are over there. Let me know if you need anyone to help you load them onto your ship. Hondo bows and gives thanks. Just then, Isabel notices an incoming First Order patrol. A transport loaded with stormtroopers advances, with the TIE echelon circling above for support. Interesting. How should we play this? Flee, open fire. I don't have a blaster. God damn it. I don't have a detonator, so I can't throw one of those. I don't have a fake ID, so our only option is to flee to the Falcon. Yikes. Something tells me this deal is not going to go over well. Maybe I should have waited. Perhaps it would have been wiser to wait. If this ends, like, right here, I'm just going to do another mission. Okay. Alright. There's no shame in that. Live to fight another day, or in your case, live to run another day, teases Hondo. The crew hurries to load the remaining crates and lifts off. The ground troopers open fire on the Falcon, but the deflector shields hold true. As they race away, the TIE echelon pursues them. Fly high or fly low? Let's fly low. Alright, let's see. That's not adventure music. There we go. Oh boy, alright. The Millennium Falcon flies low to the ground while the TIE echelon pursues them. Isabel steers towards the forest of towering spires. Good idea, they'll never find us after we've hit a spire and exploded into a million pieces, shouts Hondo. The Falcon twists and turns, weaving between the purified spires while the TIE echelon follows closely behind. Fire at the TIE echelon or fire at the spire formations. Formations? But then they might hit us. And if we fire at the TIE echelon, it's going to shoot back, so we're probably going to get hit anyway. Would we rather deal with hits from blasters or hits from rocks? Rocks. I really hope I didn't just make the wrong choice. Okay. Everyone's just going about their business, not knowing that there's a serious business operation going on right now. We're so lucky. Chewbacca moves to the main gun and fires at the spires. Chunks of petrified trees fly everywhere. The base of one of the spires fractures and collapses into another spire. A chain reaction of falling spires careens towards the TIE echelon, which diverts to avoid the chaos. The Falcon quickly pulls up and exits Batuu's atmosphere. Head to Coruscant. So it worked! Yay! And we didn't even get hit by falling rocks. I don't think. So we're doing good. We have successfully avoided the First Order to get out of Batuu. Now we need to deal with whoever's out in open space and whoever's in front of Coruscant twice. And then we also have to get back to Batuu. Okay. The small crew of the Millennium Falcon enters lightspeed and heads to Coruscant. The entire planet is one giant city. Our contact is meeting us on level 5127, said Hondo. The Falcon lands on an open platform. Hondo, Chewbacca, and Isabel exit the ship and meet with the contact. Pin 2, my friend. We've brought you the Lycan. Now let's make a deal so we may be on our way, declares Hondo. It took you too long. I'll only pay half, grumbles Pin 2. Accept the offer or demand more. Oh, I'm demanding more. You took too long, man. Don't get cheap on me, Pin 2. Don't get cheap on me. This is a scoundrel mission. I'm demanding more. I know Hondo would agree with me. Stay out of this. Here's your money. Don't push your luck. Well, you're still able to walk out of here on 2 feet, shouts Pin 2. Hondo mutters some choice phrases under his breath, and the group returns to the Falcon to chart a course for Batuu. Wow. Whoa, just dropped out of the sky. Dang. Well, that sucks. So, our mission didn't really go that well, I guess. That's annoying. What's this? Our mission didn't go well. Well, I mean, it went well enough, I guess. I mean, you know, we didn't get shot. It just took us a bit longer to do this job. And, we only got half our pay, which I'm sure Hondo's not happy about. Oh well. Discuss business trip outcome, I guess. That's a shame. This did not go well. Maybe he has another mission I can go on for him. That'll be a bit easier and doesn't require a fake ID or a blaster. Oh my goodness. This game. Okay. Discuss business trip outcome. Alright, Isabel, get in there. Go talk to your boss. Why can't she just sit down right next to him? She has to go behind the bar? For goodness sake. So we were late and we only got paid half as much as they promised. Happy to have you on the team, my friend. That was quite the adventure. Mission complete, 250 credits, scoundrel reputation, a bonus reward in the inventory, and another mission when we talk to Hondo. All right, what did he give us this time? Another data spike? Oh, a fake ID. Well, gee, I could have used that like 5 minutes ago. You know what, let's try and do, because we still have time. I'm going to do one more mission, just to raise some cred, because I don't know how much credit we need with the scoundrels to get, like, thermal detonators and stuff. So, we're going to do one more mission, like an easier mission, though. This one should be able to build our credit. So these two would require us to go on the Millennium Falcon again, but I don't want to do that until I have a blaster or something like that. So we're going to do this one. It's called Hot Tip, 250 credits. We get a bonus item and scoundrel credit. Information fetches the highest price in the midst of the squabbles between the Resistance and the First Order. Get as much intel as you can and you'll enjoy a good payout for sure. Alright, we'll do that. Alright, so acquire information fragments around Batuu, compile information fragments into a Batuu port. Okay, so we need to open supply crates, slice control panels, or talk to people around Batuu to gather valuable information. Alright, simple enough. Let's start here. If we can. Or is the game gonna glitch again? Intimidate for information, question for information, or seduce for information? Just because I think it's funny, I'm gonna try and seduce this person for information. Let's see. Oh, she's scared! She knows. Just don't mind me just casually seducing people. What does this look like? Oh, rejected. You know, I can't talk about that. You're making me uncomfortable. Sorry. Okay, let's try a friendly introduction. Sorry, I came on too strong. I don't like bees. Dude, I love those little speech bubbles, because they're always just random stuff. Let's enthuse about lightsabers. Let's try and, like, get to know this person before we start, like, asking them questions. Tell an unbelievable story. Then we'll question for information. Dude, why are you just standing there? This is ridiculous. Okay, that was something. I'll be willing to tell you what I know in exchange for a little something, like credits. I really like credits. Alright. If money is all that you love. So, give requested info. Okay, so she wants 100 credits? Just know I'm gonna swindle you after this. Alright, give me that information, though. Alright, what do you know? Oh, whatever. Let's go find someone else to bother. Probably wouldn't be a good idea to talk to a stormtrooper. I did say we could open some supply crates. I believe there's one right there. Let's use droid to override locks. Let's go. I guess she does need amusement. Go ahead and dance while the droid does its thing. Alright, baby, make me proud. Zoom all the way in. Wow, that's it? I can't believe that's it. Okay. Where's my droid? Follow protocol, and now I'm just gonna have to break into that crate myself. Alright, fine. Still too frustrated. How long is that gonna last? 0 minutes, alright. Alright, let's go attempt to override the locks. Oh no, of course there's a stormtrooper. Well, at least character is still dancing. Alright, stop dancing, go override the locks. Dude, what are you doing? Why are you just standing there? Okay, she's just not responding. I guess she doesn't want to go on another mission. Well, this has been a rather disappointing episode, I think. I mean, at least we got to go on the Falcon, but our mission didn't go as well as I thought it would. So let me see if I can cancel gig. Dude. Okay, I think the game is just glitching, because she just doesn't want to do anything now. So, in that case, I guess we'll just stop here, and when we start up next week, we'll cancel her second scoundrel mission and go after the Resistance again. Or go with the Resistance again, rather. Sorry that this episode was kind of boring. Yeah, that was kind of that. This episode kind of sucked. I'm sorry. If you are feeling merciful, please still go ahead and like and subscribe, despite the fact that this episode was very slow and kind of disappointing. And please tune in next week for what is hopefully going to be a way better video with the Resistance. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. Please feel free to leave a comment about what you liked, what you disliked, what you would like to see in the next episode, hopefully. and, you know, please leave a comment saying, I hope next week's episode is better, because me too, kids, me too. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I am the Mad Witch, signing out. Bye!